So I thought we would begin this evening. I want to, of course, invite our viewers to call in with questions. We don't have a backlog of questions to deliver to our panel because, of course, this is our first program of the year. But before we get some of those questions, maybe we could talk a little bit about where you see the priorities in this, the shorter session of the two years in the term, and what you'd like to see accomplished perhaps by the end of the session. Let's start with our veteran legislator, our most veteran legislature. Representative Mariani, what would you, how would you respond to that?
Well, we're on two-year cycles, as most of your audience knows. And so this year is the quote-unquote bonding capital investment cycle, although, frankly, Representative National, over the last few years, it seems like every year has turned into a bonding year. But nonetheless, it's really our big opportunity to focus most of our energies in capital investments that we make as a state in public, in the delivery of public services. So we're talking about colleges, buildings on university campuses, a lot of transportation investments, our sanitation systems, et cetera. So we're talking big money, and basically the state leverages its awesome fiscal ability to be able to leverage bonds out in the market so that we can provide those kind of building projects at a reasonable expenditure level. So I expect that a good chunk of our energy this year will be spent on putting together a big capital investment bill. Those bills tend to be the ones that offer, quite frankly, the most opportunity for bipartisan cooperation, partly because of the threshold of votes that are needed in order to pass a successful bill, but also because we're talking about projects that often overlap political boundaries. So if you have a city like Rochester, we have Republicans and Democrats, in the legislature, they'll band together and work together to make sure that there's a proper capital investment, for instance, for the University of Minnesota campus on location there. So that's one big thing that I fully expect we'll be working on. We know that there's a big federal tax bill that was passed this year, and so there's going to be a lot of energy around aligning Minnesota's tax policies with the new federal parameters, and those are quite new. And I think we'll probably spend a lot of the time up front trying to figure out how much of that conformity we should do. I think that's where you can expect some of the sharper ideas and perhaps the disagreements about just how far, how much to do relative with the federal bill. And then, of course, the other thing we do in this off year is that quote-unquote off year, budget off year, is we'll do budget adjustments. And those are going to be based, and so those are budget adjustments to the prior year's big budget decisions that we made. And those are based on forecasts that are done in the fall of the year, and then we'll expect another forecast here at the end of February. And this is going to be an interesting year because the big tax bill is going to have a big impact on what that budget, those budget expectations, the level of revenues that we can expect to have in the coming year. And so we're either going to make small budget adjustments or potentially big budget adjustments, depending on how much we conform with the federal level and how much we can realize in revenue. So it sounds a little wonky, but that's kind of our world, and it really does make a big difference, and particularly in those three big areas, in terms of how much, in what areas, to what extent the state government can continue to be a presence with Minnesotans.
Representative Nash, your thoughts on that?
Yeah, thank you. I will start off with a little bipartisan agreement. I will agree that we do have some tax conformity issues that really need to be talked through. Again, the federal tax bill, fairly new as it goes for us, and we have to make sure that we're properly aligning it to make the most positive impact for Minnesota residents as we possibly can. I would say that there are some policy issues that we really need to tackle as well. No bonding bills, but some policy things that have really popped up since the last time we were in session. And we were talking about this right before we started. Mm-hmm. Many of your viewers have been dealing with, and all of us maybe have been dealing with, some of the MNLARS things. and it's been in the newspaper a lot. And the sad part of it is it's a 10-year project that's been about $100 million worth of expenditures, and it sadly doesn't work, and folks are really getting hurt.
And you want to tell our viewers what that is? I'm sure many of them know, but
right, yeah, and we speak in acronyms so much that we just assume
well,
everybody
knows
that. Well,
and you know the lawyer in me, we want to get the record straight. So
right,
no,
so
go
for
ahead.
The record, Justice, it is the Minnesota License and Vehicle software. So when you go to renew your license plate or your tabs or you do a title transfer because you're buying a different vehicle, that's the software that we're talking about. And it was a good idea when it was launched to change and upgrade because technology changes. And the software has taken 10 years to produce. And it was launched towards the latter end of last year. And it went belly up on day one. And it sadly doesn't have the capacity to deliver on the things that Minnesotans are looking for. And we have spent the entire balance of the summer, and I've been very close to this because I'm in technology, looking at what are the solutions, what are the answers, what went wrong, and we've got some ideas on how to fix that. But I really hope that this is a bipartisan thing that we can come together on, because there are people who are being harmed by this. We have two types of deputy registrars in our state, ones that are owned publicly by counties or cities, and those that are private. And those are like a small business that use the software from the state to do the things that you need to do when you go and do those transactions with your vehicles. They're all losing money because of the poor design and quality and the fact that it doesn't work. The private registrars are, some are losing thousands of dollars a day. And to keep the doors open, the business owners are infusing their own capital into the business to keep their employees around. The publicly owned ones are at the end of last year. They would assess it to this year's coming tax roll because, for example, in my own county of Carver, they found that they spent $50,000 in overtime just to do the same job that they had been doing before. Multiply that by all the counties, and we've got a lot of money. So that's one policy area that I think that we really need to focus on. And do it very quickly, because these folks are getting hurt, and it's only through us that we can make that change. I think the other thing that we need to address, and it was in the news, and you might have seen a little bit of it, is how is the legislature going to be funded? So we're going to have to come in and take care of that. And again, I think this is a great opportunity for us to truly be bipartisan, because what unfunding the legislature essentially means is that your constituents' voices and my constituents' voices aren't properly being represented if that were to not be addressed. So that's something that we'll have to deal with when we come back. All the other things that Representative Mariani mentioned are true. We're going to be in a bonding year, and I hope that we make wise decisions in how to invest in fixed infrastructure and making sure that we're taking care of the things that we own.
And you know, one of the challenges, and I concur, and I think there's strong bipartisan interest going in on the MNLARS fix. I know my caucus has spent quite a bit talking about this as well, and I suspect yours as well. So it's all about good governance. You know, it's fixable. You know, it's not, I was going to say it's not rocket science, but there is science involved. It's really about, you know, having a good game plan,
right.
You know, from the very beginning. So I think, you know, as challenging as any of the work in front of us, including this conformity issue with the federal tax bill, I think one of the challenging things we're going to be faced is that we're looking at basically 10 weeks of being in session. So this is kind of about as late as we've ever started.
It'll just feel like a year.
And well, I suspect we're talking about 48-hour days, lots of weekends. But, you know, that's certainly going to add some pressure. You know, we're human beings, and you know, there's a lot of good, sharp, energetic, people in the legislature. But you know, you also want to make sure you make really good decisions. And when we're pushing to do those in a short period of time, there's lots of opportunities for things to go wrong.